Welcome back, everybody, to our special commitment 2011 hot seat debate. I'm Camille Whitworth. I'm standing in tonight for Norman Robinson. We're talking with the four candidates running for sheriff in St. Bernard Parish. Once again, Barry Bernatus is the only Republican. Everyone else here, Chad Clark, Wayne Landry, and James Pullman, all Democrats. All right, at this point, we'd like to give each of you an opportunity to ask one another a question, and you will have 1 minute's time to respond. Mr. Pullman, your turn to go first here.
I'd ask Mr. Landry a question. 30 years ago, he claims he took some college courses in police operations, and that was around 30 years ago. Do you think those courses 30 years ago can help you in any way lead the sheriff's department?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you know, the things that I've learned 30 years ago are everything from planning patrol, arrest, conviction, and corrections. Those ideas that I've learned are the theory of the entire field of law enforcement. That did not change that theory. What I've learned back then should be implemented now, and we wouldn't be talking about the major drug problems, the speeding in the neighborhoods. We wouldn't be talking about those things that have failed right now in the sheriff's office.
Okay, good question. Thank you. Mr. Bernatus, you are up next to ask whomever you'd like.
I don't have a question to ask.
Okay, and would you like to tell us why?
I know all these gentlemen. They're all fine gentlemen. I just think I'm the most qualified to run the sheriff's office, and I have no questions to ask. Thank you.
Okay, we'll move right along then. Mr. Clark, your turn.
Mr. Landry, first of all, you said that you're going to investigate the functions of the Miro Foundation. I think it's clear to everyone and all of the people of the metropolitan area that the Miro Foundation is being investigated by the Department of Justice. I think that's very clear. Secondly, I would like to know how you could effectively be a full-time active sheriff out on the streets every day running and operating and owning 20 plus businesses.
All right, let me see if I can respond to you where the people can understand this. First of all, the Merrill Foundation investigation is not the issue here. The investigation that I'm talking about is the corruption of the sheriff's office and the abuse of power for the sheriff to get involved in it. Listen, if this lady right here had $500 million and she wanted to give it away to her daughter, she has the right to do that. It is not the sheriff's business. As far as the people are going, I've already started an investigation into it. And let me tell you something. If the sheriff would have ordered Mr. Pullman to go and rob a bank, and he robs that bank, but his motive is not to keep the money, but to get their support to run for sheriff, he's still guilty of robbing the bank. There's no difference. And that's what that investigation is about. Not the Merrill Foundation per se, but what happened with the sheriff's office involvement into it. The second part of your question was my businesses. First of all, I don't own 23 businesses anymore. If you keep up, you'd know that I divested myself from all of them. And in fact, my nursing home is up for sale as we speak. So whether, no matter how the selection goes, that's for sale, and I don't actually manage it, but I own those properties.
Mr. Landry, okay, you're coming up right on time. Your turn for a question.
All right, my question is to Mr. Pullman. And my question is, Jack Stevens appointed him to the board that made the key decision of where the hospital will be located. Everyone knows there were only two choices. One was the Village Square, one was the Merrill Foundation land. If we'd have pulled the hospital on the Village Square, we'd have picked up an extra $14 million from the federal government and $2 million savings in infrastructure. Since Jack Stevens appointed you to that board, and Jack Stevens is also a member of the Merrill Foundation and the guy you take orders from, my question is, do you think it was a conflict of interest for you to have voted on that issue?
No.
Do you care to expound on that?
No. It's not a conflict of interest. I'm just a representative of the Sheriff's Department that sits on this board. And the thing that Mr. Landry's talking about is taken way out of content. He claims that I was the deciding vote. I was not the deciding vote. The chair breaks the tiebreaker. Secondly, there was another option at the Prince of Peace Church location for a hospital, as you know. And that option was still on the table, but the Merrill property was already picked. And I wasn't looking to misappropriate property from any landowners back there. I didn't want to slow the hospital project down because Lord knows we need a hospital back there, and that's what I based my decision on, as simple as that. But as far as the corruption and the sheriff, you know, I found it funny that 4 years ago, Wayne Landry took out a full-page ad endorsed Sheriff Jack Stevens, the one who had claimed you're so corrupt, and you poured money into his campaign finance for a sheriff that you think is so corrupt, and your 83-year-old father still collects a paycheck from Jack Stevens, who you think is so corrupt.
And performs a job.
Okay. Right up on time. You guys are right up to the buzzer there. All right. Good job on that. Thank you very much. All right. I do have a question, if you don't mind. I'm going to throw this in. We've all seen the commercials. This is a race that is really getting heated and in some cases downright nasty. Mr. Bernadius, we're going to start with you. Why do you think that this race has gotten that way so far?
I don't really know. I haven't participated in any of that. I'm not a mudslinger. I truly believe that the person that should get this job should be the most compassionate and the most experienced in law enforcement, both in education and training. The race, it's one other reason is this is the first time this job's actually been open in 27 years. And all four men here are qualified to take that job. I just think that I'm more qualified. But it has gotten ugly, and it's really a shame because, you know, for the most part, we all know each other, and we see each other, and it's really a shame that it's gotten that way.
Mr. Clark?
I agree with Mr. Bernadius. I don't think there should be any mudslinging. I'm not sure actually why it's going on. I believe that if you decide to run for a position like this, you should run on what you believe in, your experience, your training, and the plan that you have to bring the sheriff's office where it needs to be.
Mr. Landry?
I think it's real funny that none of my opponents have slung any mud towards me. You know, the attacks on me were personal, have nothing to do with the sheriff's office race. As you heard me answer Mr. Clark's question to me, the issue of the Merrill Foundation, I believe wholeheartedly, is an issue, and it's symbolic of what has been going on in our sheriff's office. And I think that's why people need to make a distinction. Look, I can talk about all of our infidelities up here. I'm not going that way. That would be personal and off the issues of the campaign, but I'm here to tell you that none of them are better than me in that regard. But at the end of the day, the issue of the sheriff's office with that Merrill Foundation, I think, is a critical issue, and it shows how the power brokers have controlled that office for nearly 30 years, and that's why you see me putting that issue out on the street.
Mr. Pullman, why did this race get so nasty?
Because my opponent is willing to spend $200,000 on a negative campaign. My campaign has been positive. I'm very proud of my 28-year career with the Sheriff's Department. This department does not have any type of corruption within that department. I take offense to Mr. Landry insinuating that this department has corruption within it. Over the 28 years that I've been at the Sheriff's Department, we not have not one deputy indicted for corruption. And that's a record that we're very proud of. And that's why I run my campaign on a positive note. I'm very proud of my career. I'm very experienced. Last 4 years, I've been chief deputy. I'm doing a great job. I think it tells when the department's doing a great job. And I think people are going to judge me simply on the job that I do and nothing else.
Okay. I have one other question. Let's talk about the violence, the weapons in St. Bernard Parish. Let's talk about what you think the problem is and what you plan to do about it. Mr. Clark, you first.
You know, I think that comes with beefing up proactive police units. Right now, we currently have, I was in charge of, prior to me taking a leave of absence, I was a commander of the Special Investigations Division, which includes street crimes and narcotics, which is the most proactive division on the sheriff's office. And again, drugs is the number one problem. As far as the weapons go, we seize probably 15 to 20 weapons a year, which at the end of the day, I don't think that's a whole bunch. You know, taking guns off the street, you know, based on traffic stops and executing search warrants that we do.
Okay. Mr. Landry?
Let me answer you like this. Other than the major drug problem we have, other than the speeding in the neighborhoods that we have, other than the crimes associated with the drug problem, the theft and the stabbings like what occurred the other night and those things, St. Bernard's pretty safe, right? Let me tell you something. When you use the money right and you put more patrolmen out in the neighborhoods and you're proactive and you do routine, random, aggressive patrols, you can begin to get intelligence on that. You can begin to get the public trust back in that department. You can begin to get to those things before they occur. Now, you're not going to always get there before it occurs, and I understand that. But you're going to reduce the frequency of those things happening by being proactive and by spending the money to at least increase a minimum of 15% more patrolmen out in the neighborhoods. And that's how you attack that problem and all those other problems.
Mr. Pullman.
Intelligence-based community policing, our crime tracker program, allows us to watch crime trends, monitor those crime trends, and develop strategies to make sure we deploy our assets to deal with those type of things. We don't see a lot of violent crime in the parish, but when we do, we make sure that we're on top of it by deploying manpower. We have a great narcotics and street crimes unit. They don't allow anybody to get any type of drug turf wars going on. They get out there. As soon as we get information that we have some drug activity on certain areas, we make sure that we deploy that unit, and that unit goes out and hits it, and they hit it hard. And that's why you don't see the level of violence in terms of drug dealing that you do in other areas of the metropolitan area.
Mr. Bernatis?
During the last 6 years of my 23-year career with the FBI, I worked intelligence. Intelligence will be huge in my department. It's probably going to be one of the biggest segments of the department. Part of the community policing program that Mr. Pullman speaks about will deal with neighborhood watch groups. No one knows their neighborhoods better than the neighbors that live there. As far as the violence in St. Bernard Parish, I don't think we have as much violence as in New Orleans or Jefferson Parish, but there could be a tendency for it to get greater. The St. Bernard Parish Sheriff's Office currently has license plate recognition cameras currently in use in St. Bernard, but unfortunately the data is not being utilized. I'm going to hire intelligence analysts to make sure that data is utilized, and that way we can develop trends as far as who's coming and who's going in St. Bernard Parish.
Okay, one further question. The current Sheriff Jack Stevens, the longest serving sheriff in Louisiana, not seeking re-election on October 22nd. Mr. Landry, we'll start with you. Why is it time for a new sheriff in town?
Well, I think, first of all, I've been very vocal in what I think the issues are in the sheriff's office, and you've heard me mention them here tonight. You know, I think that the sheriff's office has put a lot of despotic things going on in there. People's family members, one after another, are hired, rank and file. The payroll has in excess of $800,000 a year of deadhead payroll. I think all of those problems, coupled with a lot of contracts that people aren't aware of that are very lucrative to people that actually perform no functions. That and the public trust has been betrayed, I believe, by the sheriff. And I think one of the reasons he's not running again, he just recently stepped down from the Merrill Foundation board. I think that negative has brought him to the point where he can no longer win, and that's why he stopped. But I think the people of St. Bernard are ready for a new sheriff in town, someone that's not associated with that sheriff's office, so they can come in and use the people's money for what it's supposed to be, their safety first.
Mr. Pullman, you're up time there. Mr. Pullman?
Well, I think the sheriff was going to retire 4 years ago, but we had Hurricane Katrina blow through, and they had a lot of rebuilding needed to be done with infrastructure and the department as a whole, and I think that's why he made it a decision to run last time. But I think the sheriff has served us well. I think this department had come a long way. I started my career here back under then-Sheriff Ralph McDougal before Sheriff Stevens even was in office. So I saw leaps and bounds on the way this department had transformed into one of the greatest sheriff's offices in the state. But when it comes to a point in time when you make your decisions based on politics rather than the business decisions, I think, you know, that's when it's time to move on and have somebody fresh come in that's not going to make political decisions, it's going to make basically business decisions for the sheriff's department. That's what I bring to the department.
Mr. Bernatis.
If the sheriff would have retired 4 years ago instead of running again, he wouldn't have had to throw me out the race by utilizing his secretary to sue me for residency because I lost my house during Hurricane Katrina. As far as the sheriff's concerned and the office is stale. These two gentlemen up here that currently work for the sheriff's office do a great job, but their policies and procedures are stale. You need someone that's not involved with the sheriff's office currently. You need fresh new ideas, and I believe I bring that.
Mr. Clark?
I think the sheriff's done a pretty good job over the last 28 years that he's been in office. Is there room for improvement? Absolutely. I think St. Bernard Parish is changing, and I think we need to change with it. I'm the only candidate that has a plan in place that is going to bring the sheriff's office to where I believe it needs to be.
Okay, gentlemen, thank you so much. My producer does tell me that we can take one more viewer question. Let's get straight to it. And this one has to do with possible corruption, okay? Will you protect and serve the people of St. Bernard or play favorites to the people with the most money? Mr. Pullman, you first.
I think I kind of just covered that. You know, I think we need to take more of a business approach at the sheriff's department rather than a political approach. What I bring to this department, I'm a second-generation lawman. I started my career here. I'm a professional law enforcement professional. I have 28 years of experience. I'm currently the chief deputy. I've been doing that job for nearly 4 years. I'm currently a graduate of FBI's National Academy. I think I'm the best trained and most experienced candidate in this race to bring this department forward.
Mr. Bernatis?
Well, I have not taken any money from anyone except the retired parish president, Lynn Dean. I don't have any political ties to anyone. I don't have any political ties to any business. As far as being the most trained. I've been in the FBI Academy 37 times, CIA Academy, National Geographic Spatial Institute. As far as training, no one tops me in training. I also have a business background. When I worked for the FBI, I was a supervisor at the FBI, supervising the major programs there, and I also own my own business. So I believe I'm the most qualified.
Mr. Clark.
I have 18-plus years of experience on the Sheriff's Office now. I'm a graduate of the FBI National Academy. I'm also a graduate of the FBI's LEADS, which is I'm one of 2,000 graduates worldwide. As far as the corruption side of this goes, one of the plans that we have is to put an OPR in place, which is an Office of Professional Responsibility, to take complaints from citizens, and that's going to be an outside group that manages this section of the Sheriff's Office.
Mr. Landry.
Let me answer your question that was asked, okay? Absolutely, I will put the safety of the people first. Look, I'll stand up for the people of St. Bernard, and I'll take the personal attacks just to be able to do that. Most of the money in my campaign is my money. It's my investment back in our parish because I believe that somebody needs to step up and stand up for the people of St. Bernard. As far as taking from money from the powerful or giving it to them, you talk about a test drive, they've had a test drive with me. I fought the powers that be in building that hospital to keep those people with the money out of it. And I'll continue to do so, and I'll continue to use our money for our people. That answers your question.
All right. It has indeed been a spirited debate. Stand by, everybody, because coming up next, each candidate gets 1 minute to try to convince you that they deserve to be the very next sheriff of St. Bernard Parish. Don't go away. We'll be right back.